Hi everyone, it's Don, and I hope you're having a fantastic day. Well, some things in the news today is we have Celebrity canceling one of her ships. Again, changes to Royal Caribbean's itinerary. I want to show you a little bit of how to double check what your cancellation policy rules are. And some people just think, oh, I'm just going to get FCCs and I'm not going to get any money back. That might not be necessarily the case. And then I have a story about a passenger who is really, really upset with an itinerary change and wants me to tell them how much they should ask Royal Caribbean back for money because of this itinerary change. Well, wait till you hear the itinerary change. So the first story up is Celebrity Eclipse has been canceled now. All sailings from March 26th up to April 16th. Now, most of these, if not all of them, included ports of call along the West Coast. So San Francisco, California area. And with the recent changes and restrictions at some of the ports, like San Francisco just last week came out and said, everybody has to have a booster shot or everybody has to be tested getting off at the port. Well, they decided to cancel all those cruise ships and now they won't be bringing that ship back into service until April 23rd. Bad news for the crew. They were hoping to get back to work. Bad news for a lot of people who are looking to sail along the West Coast with Celebrity. But it is what it is right now. Another story out there right now going around, and if you listen to the news media, you're gonna hear it's a horrible story. It's the worst story you've ever heard. That's right. The Norwegian Gem left on a 10-day cruise, got a few days into the cruise, and the captain announced, sorry, everybody. I'm afraid we have to cancel the cruise due to COVID. They didn't say whether it's COVID on board, whether it's COVID restrictions. They didn't really give very much detail other than say they have to cancel the cruise and you're going to end up getting your money back because they're canceling the cruise, which, you know, not bad news. So a lot of people said, well, I guess we're just going to turn around, head back to New York. And it turns out that's not the case. They're going to spend more days at sea. So here's the situation. You're getting basically a free cruise. You're still getting your 10-day vacation. The only thing is you're not able to go to ports, but you're getting all your money back. So some people are absolutely loving this, saying, okay, yes, it's limited on board. There's not a lot of people on board, so there's not a lot to do. You know, and the shows are limited compared to that, but the food is there, the entertainment staff is there, the specialty dining restaurants are there, the piano bars are there, everything else is there, the ocean's there, and I'm sailing for 10 days for free, basically. But then you see the stories coming out, like from USA Today, where it's turning into a nightmare. Well, if that's a nightmare cruise, I'll take that as my nightmare cruise every single time. Oh my goodness, I'm stuck at sea for 10 days and they're giving me my money back. Yet I have free roam of the ship. I can still go do things. Yeah, that doesn't sound like a nightmare to me. You know, nightmare is the engine breaks down at sea and all the plumbing stops working. That's a nightmare cruise. This is not a nightmare cruise. But thanks for the headline, USA Today. You know, it's always good to put that spin on all your stories. So yeah, I think it's a nothing story, but apparently USA thinks it's a nightmare cruise. Maybe they should try cruising once in a while before they write about it. Okay, now I also want to talk to you a little bit about your cancellation policies. Now, some cancellation policies, go in, read what that cancellation policy is for, you know, the COVID protection and stuff like that. If you are have to cancel your cruise within 48 hours, within 60 days, within 30 days, anytime past your final payment date. Now, if you're canceling your cruise before final payment, whatever the cancellation policy in place is, that's what's there. But you can sometimes still cancel with, you know, cruise with confidence, and instead of losing that non-refundable deposit, you might be able to get that as future cruise credits. So check that out. But here's a perfect example. If you go into Princess Cruise Lines, their policy is, you know, if you cancel 30 days before your cruise or longer, so 60 days, 45 days, if you cancel 30 days before your cruise, you will get, you know, all the penalties for cancellation as future cruise credits. Now, what that means is whatever's not a penalty, you would get back in cash, back on your credit card. And for example, I looked at my booking for my Panama Canal cruise, and if I cancel, say, 31 days before my cruise, it falls under a 50% penalty. So I would get 50% of my money back, and then the 50% penalty I would get as future cruise credits. So it's not always totally future cruise credits. You could actually get cash back. And that also might, you know, it might not be 50% for your cruise line. It might be 25%. It might be 30%. So it's worth looking into what the actual cancellation policy is for each cruise line and for your cruise in particular. You might be surprised and say, hey, I'm getting my money back and I have just a, you know, $400 in future cruise credits, or $1,000 instead of what I thought was going to be $5,000. It could be the big difference between waiting a little longer to cancel your cruise in these uncertain times, or just canceling them outright. It just might be more worth your benefit. Okay, I have this story of a passenger who sent me an email. I'm not going to show the names or anything like that, who is asking me, because they're very irate at this change to their itinerary, and they want to know how much they should ask Royal Caribbean for onboard credits or money off their cruise. Before I get into that story, let me just invite you to hit that subscribe button if you haven't done so already. If you like this kind of content, if you want to keep up to date with all the things going on with cruising, the no sail order, the CDC, the restrictions in port, the testing policies, the refund policies, cruise itineraries, cancellations, ship logs, ship itineraries, all things cruising. It's as simple as that. It really does help the channel out if you subscribe, and I would really, really appreciate it. Okay, so I get this message about the Allure of the Seas, and the Allure is leaving on the 22nd of January. So just in a couple weeks, and its original itinerary was going to be day one, stopping in Nassau. Day two was a sea day. Day three, four, and five, they would stop in this order, St. Thomas, St. Martin, St. Kitts, and then they would have two sea days on their way back to Florida. Okay. Sounds like a reasonable itinerary. Sounds like, you know, all the saints are there. But Norwegian has, Royal Caribbean has come out and said, nope, they have to change this because of port docking that's conflicting with other ships. There's too many ships going into a port at the same time. So Nassau remains the same. The first sea day remains the same. And then they're going to stop in St. Thomas, which is what they were supposed to do. But then they're going to go to St. Kitts the day that they were supposed to go into St. Martin. And then they're going to go to St. Martin the day they were supposed to go to St. Kitts. And then they're going to have their two sea days. That's the big switch. They're switching the days one after another, back to back, that they were going to St. Martin and St. Kitts. That's the huge itinerary change that this person wants to know how much they should ask Royal Caribbean back money because of their itinerary change. How about this? How about just be glad you got ports to go to? How about you be glad that Royal Caribbean has thought ahead to see that there could be a possible problem at a cruise port with too many ships where they might get denied, and made some rearranging of the schedule, hopefully so you have no interruption in your stops? I think people should stop looking to try and get money back for every little thing that goes wrong. Like I said, if you're a cruiser and you've been cruising any length of time, you know things can happen. It's just like going on Disney. You go to Disney and you expect to get on, I'm going on that ride for sure. And then you get to Disney World and that ride is closed. Do you go to Disney World and scream that you want your entire vacation money back? No. Yeah, don't. Well, some people do. But I don't. Yeah. So here I'm responding to that person right here in an open video. And the video says, yeah, don't ask him for any money. Just enjoy your cruise. Just be happy you're going. I wish I was able to go right now. I'm just too busy. And so I can't go until my next cruise next month. But I guarantee you, if they change a port of call and switch the two ports around, I'm not asking for my money back. Well, I hope you appreciate this little bit lighter side of the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Want to see more tips, more tricks, more travel vlogs from around the world? Hit that subscribe button. Till next time, have yourself a safe and a great vacation. And enjoy your cruise ports.